Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to go over the waggle dance of the honeybee. Honeybees are social insects that live in large colonies. They have developed dances to let other bees about to leave the hive to go forage know where they got their yield from. These dances serve as an important form of communication between bees and the hive. There are three different dances a honeybee may engage in that all communicate different information. The first type of dance is known as the round dance. During this kind of dance, the foraging bee returns to the hive and an exchange of nectar occurs. They then make a series of tight circles over the comb of the hive, frequently changing directions. This goes on for a few seconds up to a few minutes. This dance is used when the food source is nearer to the hive. No directionality is conveyed through this dance. The amount of energy and enthusiasm used by the bee in the dance conveys the quality of pollen or nectar nearby. The second type of dance is called the waggle dance. During this kind of dance, the bee returns to the hive and food sharing occurs between the returning bee and the bees at the hive. The bee will then engage in a figure eight pattern. This pattern includes a period of abdomen shaking in the middle straight part of the figure eight. This is the waggle phase of the waggle dance. At the end of the waggle phase, the bee turns to the right and returns back to the beginning point of the waggle portion. This is called the return phase. The bee will then do another waggle portion. It will then turn to the left and return to the beginning, completing the figure eight pattern. This dance is repeated many times by the returning bee. This type of dance is used when the food source is further away from the hive. This type of dance provides a range of information to the other worker bees. The direction of the waggle phase gives information on the direction of the food source. This directional information of the food source is often given in relation to its position to the sun. For example, a food source found directly in line with the sun, the bee will direct their waggle dance upwards on the comb. For food sources found not in line with the sun but at an angle to the sun, the bee changes the direction of the waggle phase on the comb. The waggle phase is done at a corresponding angle to either side of upwards on the comb. The duration of the waggle phase gives information on the distance of the food source from the hive. The further away the food source, the longer the waggle phase will be. The dance tempo of the waggle section, so how rapid it wiggles its abdomen, gives information on the quality of the food source. The better quality of the food source, the more enthusiastic a bee will do this waggle portion to try convince the other bees to go to their food source versus others also doing waggle dances in the hive. The third kind of dance is the dorsoventral abdominal vibrating dance. The function of this dance differs to the other two dances. This dance involves the worker bee vibrating their abdomens in the dorsoventral or vertical plane. This is usually done whilst in contact or clasping another bee. The first thing this dance is used for is in regulating foraging patterns in relation to changes in food supply. It is used at times during the day and during the year where there are periods of reduced food supply. This vibration dance is used to recruit other workers for foraging in these times when increased foraging is needed. This type of dance is also used in swarm management. This vibration dance is used on the queen during the period when new queens are being reared. This vibration on the queens is thought to control the timing of swarming. Swarming, which is the process in honeybees where the hive splits into two, often occurs after this dance on the queen has stopped. The queen will leave with the swarm to form a new hive, and the new queens laid by the existing queen that is now left will take over the existing hive. This vibrating dance is also used on the new developing queens to control the timing of nuptial flights taken by these new queens. And that concludes this video on the different dances of the honeybee. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.